Do you want to know what marriage was like for Vikings? This video will be about the history of marriage in Viking culture. We'll talk about how they got married, what happened after they were wed, and everything else you need to know about their wedding traditions. So buckle up, because this one will be good. Rituals before and after marriage. Before marrying, the Viking man would go to live with his partner at her house for 1 year. If at the end of that year she seemed agreeable, he would take her home as his wife. Romantic. The Vikings practiced polygamy, meaning that they could be married to more than one woman at the same time. In this case, a man would have to divide his time equally between his wives and help support them financially. If he didn't do that, he could risk being punished for mistreating his wives. Now this isn't romantic. Are you enjoying the video so far? Then why not give it a like and subscribe to the channel? Done? Let's continue. Divorce as common culture. Divorce was very common in the Viking culture. Men would trade their wives for land, social status, livestock, food, or weapons. Breaking a marriage contract means breaking the law. The Vikings would switch spouses very frequently. Divorce was used by the Vikings to achieve their needs and desires both for men and women. Women could break an engagement or simply leave their husband without any consequences. She would have to repay the dowry to have separation papers drawn up. The Vikings viewed marriage as an economical transaction in most cases. Hand fasting and bride's father. The Vikings are well known for their fearless raids and brutal takeovers of foreign civilizations. But one thing they were equally known for before their violent conquests was hand fasting. Hand fasting is basically a wedding ceremony where the bride and groom stay married for a year and a day. It usually consisted of the groom proposing marriage or hand fasting to the bride's father, who would then accept or refuse the proposal. If he refused, the groom may challenge him to a holmgang duel, kidnap his daughter as a last resort, or go raiding on another country with fellow Vikings. What marriage was for Vikings. The Vikings did practice something called a sigit, which is often translated as marriage in the modern sense of the term. However, this was not a universal practice among all Vikings groups. What does seem to be true is that sigit was an institution involving rules and obligations for those considered fully grown Vikings. In other words, women who were given away as brides at the point of puberty or later were expected to comply with social mores around their husband's rights and responsibilities. Young girls married to old men. Vikings such as Rollo and Ragnar often married young girls to old men. This was not only because the Vikings wanted to save girls from the pagan gods, but also because they were afraid that young girls would be raped by other Vikings or non-Vikings, so they decided it is better for a girl to marry at once than leaving her unmarried and live alone in that harsh society. We will wrap up today's video here. We hope you have found it interesting. We would love to know your thoughts in the comments section. And before you go, make sure you have subscribed to the channel and press the bell icon. We will keep bringing you more interesting videos, so stay with us, and we will see you in the next one.